Today I'm going to discuss a very important topic of English grammar, and the name of the topic is clause. Clause, let us begin with the definition. According to the definition, clause is a part of sentence that contains a subject and a predicate. So from the definition, it is quite clear that clause is a part of sentence that contains a subject and a predicate. So when I say subject and a predicate, what is the meaning of these two words? Subject is any part of a clause or a sentence that is talked about. That means subject is always the main part of a clause or a sentence. Subject is either a noun or a pronoun. We should always keep in mind that subject will either be a noun or be a pronoun. Next is predicate. Predicate is the part of sentence rather than the subject. So any part of the sentence apart from subject in the sentence or a clause is known as predicate. See the example. He is a good boy. She is a good girl. So see, in the first example, he is the subject as it is a pronoun. As I've already told that subject is always either a noun or a pronoun. And in the second example, she is the subject. And these two words are the words that are being talked about. Means the whole sentence is based on the subject, and the rest of the part is a good boy and is a good girl is the predicate. So the part of the sentence apart from subject is known as the predicate. Now types of clause. There are two types of clause: independent clause and dependent clause. So what is independent clause? They can stand on their own, which means they can form complete sense on their own. That is why they are called complete sentence. Independent clause are the type of clause that form a complete meaning. By reading those clause, we get a complete sense. We can understand the meaning of those clause. That is why they are called as complete sentence. Example C. Anshika is a good girl. Ankita is very naughty. So in these two examples, see, Anshika and Ankita are the subject, and is a good girl and is very naughty is the predicate. So after reading these two clause, we get a complete sense. We can understand what is being told in this clause. That is why independent clause are known as a complete sentence. Now next type of clause is